Yeah, it's International Chest Day. Monday, you know what that means. It's the most glorious day of the week. And also, I gotta get going to the gym to get my pump on. So I will see you there at the gym because, like I said, it is Chest Day, the most glorious day of the week. Yeah, and that's what I get for doing chest on a Monday. All the benches were taken because, like I said, it's International Chest Day. Monday's International Chest Day every single week. But what's going on, guys? Welcome to the video. This is the first time you tuned into one of my videos. My name is Eric of the Saiyan Lifestyle. I make videos like this every single week to help men build their dream physique. Now, what guy doesn't want to build a big chest? I mean, that's the first goal almost any guy has when they come into the gym. They automatically gravitate towards the bench press, which, just a quick thing for this video, if you think I'm going to mention the bench press in one of these moves, you're sorely mistaken. So if that pisses you off, offends you, you snowflake, then please exit the video because it's like include that. But if you do want some serious gains, feel free to stay in this video because I promise you, if you do these three exercises and do it the way I say, you're going to reap some serious chest gains. Now guys, like I said, the chest is one area that men want to build up more than anything else. They want to get that big barrel chest so they can walk into the gym and feel like the dominant alpha male when they walk in. Because what guy doesn't look at a guy with a big chest and go, man, he looks dominant. And why do these 40, 50 year old guys who are clearly like 30 years past their prime always talking about how much they could bench in high school? Because it matters a lot to them. But guys, here's the thing. If you're trying to achieve a bigger chest and even get a bigger bench press, which yes, doing these dumbbell movements and dumbbell benching is going to help you achieve a big chest and a bigger bench press. Because I actually know quite a few guys that really don't barbell bench press all that much. I do personally because I'm a power lifter. They rarely do that, but yet they have a big chest and they have a crazy, I just kind of hit my closet door. They have a crazy high bench press and they really don't ever do it. So yes, it is possible to build a strong bench press and a big chest by just using dumbbells. So if you are ready to learn what these movements are and to reap some serious chest gains, let's get into it. Well, first of all, guys, I really don't like bringing science too much into the equation since I believe it's a bunch of humble jumble numbers, this and that, and it confuses people more than it should. And people think that just because of a 0.00 whatever percent, that's going to matter a whole lot, which it really won't. I want to bring simplicity back to working out. And this one, a few times I'm going to use science because it's basic anatomy. So I love using basic anatomy to understand what works best for guys. And guys, when it comes to basic anatomy, your chest is not built the way you think it is. I know you may look at anatomical diagrams in your high school bio book or whatever, but in reality, that's so inaccurate when it comes to the chest. Your pec fibers actually don't go straight across your chest like this. They don't. In fact, most people's chest fibers, about 99.98% of the population, either go slightly up like this, kind of at like a 23 degree angle, or slightly down like this at like a 15-20 degree angle. It does not go straight across, it either goes slightly down or slightly up. So quickly with me, do this exercise to see which pec fibers you have more of and which way your pec naturally goes. So I want you to, of course, flex one side of your chest. I want your hand to be on it. So first, I want you to bring your arm down. So you're feeling your lower pec fibers contract. See? Down. If you're feeling a really hard contraction up here, or most of your chest activate, your lower fiber dominant. But then I want you to bring your upper chest up like that. For me, I don't feel as many because I'm lower chest dominant, but if you feel more of a chest activation that way, like you have more chest fibers activating, then more of your chest fibers are going up. rarely, if ever, are they going to go this way, or rarely ever are they going to be perfectly like half and half here and here. They're almost always going to be more naturally down this way or up this way. So going flat bench is really not going to work. So if you do want to get the best chest gains possible, you got to go in the direction that the muscle fibers are going. And you've got to learn your own body too. Now I know some of you are about to bring this up that, hey, Eric, in your videos, I see you benching. Well, I'm a powerlifter, so I need to be proficient at that lift. And even I throw in dumbbell benching into my program. I only bench like barbell bench that one time a week. Everything else is either body weights or dumbbells because I see the serious benefit when it comes to that. So without further ado, let's just get right into the exercises. The first one you're gonna do is a dumbbell decline bench press. I know I said I'm not going to include any of the barbell movements, and there's a reason why. You can actually get a greater range of motion without the barbell. Yes, I know you can use the argument that you can lift more weight with a barbell, meaning more chest is broken down. But then if you watch the video right here, you can actually go past your chest and get a really deep stretch in your muscles and then push through all the way and really get that hard contraction. So you are getting a massive range of motion, better than you would have with a barbell. Plus with a barbell, your hands are kind of fixed. So if you do have shoulder issues, it's gonna be a little bit of hell and be quite a bit of hell on your shoulder. Whereas the dumbbell, you're free to move the dumbbells around as you see fit. And what I do is I actually try to turn my hands at a 45 degree and then come down. It's gonna reduce a lot of the strain on my shoulder. The decline bench is going to hit the lower chest really hard. And I know you might be thinking that, hey, dips does the same thing. Well, dips, in my experience, at least for me, my personal experience and my client's experience, is far more of a tricep exercise than anything else. So definitely stick with this if you want those lower chest gains. The decline bench is going to activate the lower chest a whole lot more than the dips ever could. So if you are more lower pec dominant, remember the exercise I did? If you're more lower pec dominant, include most of this. Make that about, if you're doing like however many sets of a chest you're doing for your workout, make sure you do about 70%. So majority of your work is the decline work to really grow that big pec. Now the second one is going to be an incline dumbbell bench press. And as you notice in this video, like I'm showing you right here, I am not doing at the typical 45 degrees that most incline benches are set at, because in all honesty, that activates the shoulders way too much. And I have a lot of people and clients, both in person while I was a personal trainer and online clients, who tell me that, well, they feel weight a lot on their shoulder more than they do in their upper chest. The moment I tell them, hey, take it to about 20 or 30 degrees, they feel a whole lot more in their upper chest. So you want to do that little tweak when it comes to this exercise. This one is also, you want to make sure your shoulders are shrugged back and down, your chest is sticking up, then you lower the dumbbells, try and lower them past your chest, and then press them up together. Once again, it's not going to be a barbell movement, it's going to be a dumbbell movement, because both barbell and dumbbell training is highly effective for the entire body. Like I said, I know a lot of guys who train exclusively barbell, or not barbell, exclusively train dumbbell, they have some of the best chests I've ever seen, and they kill when it comes to the barbell movements too. So it's very beneficial. And plus, when you switch it to the 30 degrees, it's going to get killer upper chest activation. So if you guys are mostly chest dominant, I would suggest putting the bench at about 20 to 30 degrees and doing, like I said, 70% of your chest work with this. Because a few people I do know are very upper chest dominant. So do this one for about 70% of your working sets and make sure you go heavy with this. Guys also make the mistake that when it comes to these movements, they don't want to go too heavy. You want to make sure you are pushing yourself when it comes to these dumbbells. You can easily fail the dumbbell. All you got to do is just drop it on your side. It might be a loud bang, but that's all right. At least people know you're lifting heavy and making gains. But it's totally okay to fail the dumbbells. Not going to hurt you at all, or hurt you as bad, I should say. So the incline dumbbell bench is going to be a movement that you want to master and do a lot of, especially if you are, like I said in this exercise, more upper chest dominant, because it's going to build that big upper chest. Now, the third one we're going to do, the final one, is going to be a cable or slash dumbbell fly. Personally, I prefer the cable version because you can keep tension on your chest throughout the entire movement. Now, this is one that I don't like personally, but many other guys do. I just don't like it personally because of the way it feels on my shoulder, but that's just more due to some limitations that I have personally from my shoulder injury. Still from like 2 years ago, so. But you can't lie, a lot of guys love it and it does work for them. And I've been trying to get more into it and I've actually seen the results already from doing the chest fly. If you already know this, the main job of the chest is to bring you humerus and horizontal adduction, bring it to the middle of your body. That's the main job, is to go like that. And that's what you're accomplishing with the cable fly. And since your chest is a fan-shaped muscle, meaning fibers come out like that, when you bring them all the way back, they're really going to stretch. Then when you bring your arm to the middle, they're really going to contract really hard. Now, the thing for the chest fly is that whichever side you're most dominant on, let's say you're doing like four sets of cable flies, then three sets should be where you're most dominant with your chest fibers. The last one should be where you're least dominant with the chest fibers. So if you're dominant with the upper fibers, make sure that you do either lean forward like I'm doing this video, or you have the cable pulleys stationed a little bit farther down, so you have to bring your arms up like this. And if you're more lower chest dominant, what you want to do is slouch back on the pad like I'm showing you right here, or bring the pulleys up a little bit and then fly all the way down to really activate those chest fibers. Lean a little bit forward if you have to, if it helps you. This is going to be a great exercise to not only burn out the chest, so go really super high reps to put a lot of that blood in there after you broke down your chest with doing the decline and incline bench press. And also a good one to get the mind muscle connection in. Since a lot of guys lift a lot heavier than they should, you do want to go a lot lighter, because this is a movement where you really want to feel your mind muscle connection. You really want to burn out the chest. Get that nice pump that Arnold loved. Make sure you are adding this movement towards the end of your chest workout or push workout, whatever you do, just so you can get that mind muscle connection and really make sure your chest stretches to its fullest capacity and then flexes to its fullest capacity and really get that mind muscle connection. Now guys, like I've said in this video, you want to follow either a 70-30 or 60-40 rule on this, meaning you're spending a majority of your time on whichever pec fibers go whichever way. And the ones you're least dominant in, you'll hit last, but you'll still hit because we want that full chest. Guys, that's it for the video. So if you did enjoy it, once again, drop me one of these guys. Let YouTube know that my videos are good so I can get out to more guys and help them. And also, I just appreciate it too. Make sure any topics you want me to cover, comment down below. Basically, just do what Drake is saying. And make sure when you subscribe, you turn the notification bell on, turn it to all, so that the YouTube overlords can't destroy everything. Guys, that's it for my video. Well, if you do have any additional questions or want me to give you a personalized custom workout program, all you gotta do is let me know in my Facebook group, Saiyan Warriors, and I'll get to you as soon as I can. Guys, that's it for the video. So until then, I'll see you in the next video. Let's get it, Saiyan.
Is to go even further beyond!